So we're here at the nanotechnology conference here, just outside Thessaloniki. Whoa. Okay. So who are you?
Well, I'm Kyriakos Loufakis. I'm the president of Alexander Innovation Zone, who is co-organizing this conference. It's already the 16th time that we have our annual conference. Nanotechnology and the work of Professor Logothetidis is has created a site of excellence here in our region on this particular field. I believe we are one of the most advanced places in terms of organic electronics that they have so many applications. Some of them you can see here in this beautiful beach that we have today, this beach bar that we have our celebration and our...
Is the sun coming down behind Mount Olympus?
Yes.
Actually, is that Mount Olympus?
Yes, actually that's Mount Olympus, yes.
So that's where Zeus lives, right?
Yeah, correct. No, actually this is Mount
Olympus. Oh, it's over there, okay.
Yeah,
but we could say it's there, actually. That sounds better if we say it's there. No, I'm joking. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's... Actually, yeah, this is a very important place. I mean, this is the country where the gods used to live, Mount Olympus.
The real gods. No, I'm joking.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Whatever you say.
Yeah.
Actually, it's the place where one of the biggest empires in the world have started. That's the birthplace of Alexander the Great. It is.
His home is just over there.
Yeah.
And his grave and everything, yes. And his sister is Thessaloniki.
So this is, Thessaloniki's Alexander the Great sister. So this is a very historical place. This is a place that has a history of, it's a city the last 2,300 years. And it's never been a village. It was always for 2,300 years a city. With many cultural events, it's the center of a larger area, and that's why today it's a place where we can develop technology. You know, we have four universities in the area, we have more than 120,000 students in the area, we have 20,000 graduate students in the area. That's why we can be a place important for the economy of knowledge, and that's where our future lies. And nanotechnology and the center of excellence that has been created lies within this story, this scenario of growth for our area.
It's a very inspiring place. Greece is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Greece is going to be the future of European technology. What are you going to say?
Well, we have the possibilities to become so. You see, in the past, 30, 40 years ago, in the 1960s, people in Greece were not as educated and as they are today. They were very much thirsty for work. That's why at that time our economy was based developments and investments.
Investments, yes.
On industrial investments, trying to promote and create an industry that would be able to give work to many people. The situation is very much different today. Today, most of the Greek people are educated, they have university degrees. This is proven by the number of Greeks that live and go and live abroad, and they prosper abroad. They have very good careers abroad. So we have the main ingredient to become a technology hub to become an R&D hub. We have the human capital. And this is what we have to take advantage for.
And everybody speaks English here, right?
Yes, most of the people speak English. They speak English.
Not just because they like Hollywood movies.
No. I mean, we learn, I'm a little bit older, but even at my age, learning English, when I was at school, I was taking French course. But more or less everybody, even from the 1970s, they were obliged to learn English. And today, wherever you go, you will find people. It's very difficult to find a person here in Greece who doesn't speak English. If you are at the streets and you speak English, they'll understand you and they will communicate with you and they will try to help you. But English is one part of the talents, our foreign languages is one part of the talents our people have. Our people has excellent scientific knowledge. And this is what is important, and this is why we can really become a technology center and a technology hub. Why we haven't been, why we didn't manage so far to become one? Because there are several things that we haven't done. We don't have, for example, we didn't have a place to accept investments in R&D. We had laws that caused a lot of taxes and social security to be paid. So the cost for wages was too high, despite the fact that the people themselves were receiving lower money. But these things are changing. For example, the innovation zone has recently been granted the land of 750,000 square meters, where we are going to build and make a technology park. In this technology park, we invite, and there is interest, for foreign companies to come and invest in R&D, in development of technology, to invest on innovation. We have, as I said before, the human capital, we have the land, and I hope that pretty soon we'll have also the incentives, the tax incentives, to be able to invest on research and development. The efforts that have been done so far prove that we have the capabilities. Actually, this nanotechnology center conference that is happening for the 16th year in a row proves what we are capable of doing.
And so Thessaloniki is a perfect place for amazing things to happen in future, startups,
yes,
local startups, international startups.
Indeed. We have OK Thess is an incubator, a pre-incubator. We have Invets, we have a startup bootcamp practically for startups to grow and to promote them. We have also, you know, Thessaloniki, you mentioned it several times before. Thessaloniki is in the center of a larger area. From Thessaloniki, within 3 hours driving distance, from Thessaloniki there are three capitals. Within 7 hours driving distance, there are seven capitals of seven different countries. From Bulgaria, from North Macedonia, from Albania, from Serbia, from Romania, from Bosnia and Herzegovina, from Turkey. So, and Thessaloniki also, as you have also mentioned several times, is a great place for somebody to live. It's a very nice city. There are many things to do. So young people like to live here. And you know, all over the world, the places where innovation has been developed are places that they combine those two factors, human capital and a nice place to live, because young, talented people like the ones are here today, they like to live in nice places. They don't like to live in cold and nasty places. That's why all the big innovation and technology centers are in nice places. They are in California. They are in Israel. Israel is a nice place to be.
So I'm from Denmark. So there's a very nice weather for like a few days in a year. I'm joking. But so this is a perhaps a more comfortable place.
Yes.
Comfortable
actually,
weather.
Since you're coming from Denmark, this is, you know, again, you have a lot of good universities. You have talented people. I know you are among the most competent centers for several areas, like biopharmaceuticals, like bio
design.
Enzymes, design, energy.
Yeah.
So, but why you are so developed? Because you have taken care from the very beginning to take advantage of the advantages that you have. We are starting doing this now, and we have to, you know, and we are trying to promote all these things.
But you can potentially do it without the errors that other people did. You can take shortcuts. Potentially also Danish people can just come here. There's freedom of movement. It's
yes.
We are one big country, right?
Exactly. And that's why I mentioned before that we are a very nice place to live. We have, we can provide you excellent life. You see,
and low-cost airlines to go everywhere. Ryanair, EasyJet, and Wizz Air.
Okay, some things can be done on that. We must. Actually, the airport has been recently privatized. There are a lot of works that are in progress there, and we hope that more lines will come. But coming back to your question before, when Silicon Valley started, it started in the 1940s, end of the 1940s. It took them more than 30 years to be recognized. I mean, in the 1970s, the beginning of the 1970s, very few people were speaking about Silicon Valley. We have all started speaking about Silicon Valley in mid-1970s. Today, they lead the innovation. This means two things. It means that you need time to have success in this. On the other hand, new sites where innovation was developed, it didn't take 30 years as it took in California, in San Francisco. This is because all of them, they built on the experience Silicon Valley had. So coming into the play a little bit later, we can profit from the experience that other places had. Of course, we must always see what are our advantages, and we must capitalize on them. And I said to you, our biggest advantage is the human capital.
And the EU Commission there's a new EU Commission coming up.
Uh-huh.
After kind of what they did to Greece, let's say, I'm joking, but kind of, right? They should also be very interested in helping out, right? And and promoting this also, and in maybe helping to fund some things here.
Yes, actually, I believe that it is ourselves first we have to put the terms and say where we can invest and how we can move on. But I believe that European community would like to help us, and also I believe that innovation is one of the pillars of a European community for the next years, and it should be the main pillar for the growth of Greece. And I'm happy because, you know, we have elections in 3 days here. Both major parties state that innovation is among their priorities, and I hope that this will be proven in the days after the elections.
So it's important for the jobs, but it's also important for the solutions that come out for the society that make the life better for everybody in society. And it's all derivatives of all kinds of new inventions, technology, nanotechnology, and all this kind of stuff.
Correct. You see, Albert Einstein said once that it's not possible to do exactly the same things and expect a different outcome. So it's obvious that the model we had up to now for growth cannot work anymore. We have to do something different. And being a little bit, you know, I'm saying this over and over again, but I really believe that our big advantage is human capital and all the other things that we have in order to develop innovation, to develop an economy of knowledge.